usual time is 8:05, so I'll just give some opportunity just in case someone else. Yes, see, people are now joining in, right? So hence, I will give one more minute, one more minute. Just count down, one more minute, and we'll start. Okay, so instructions very, very clear. Yes, clear, visible, right, Prateek? Come on, quick. So instructions are, as I told you, the questions will be first two pages, from first two pages. Most of them are there in the book. Almost 85 to 90% will be there from the book. But you have to be very cautious while reading the question because the
Don't
questions
change
will be
anything.
at times twisted. Okay, yes, everything is from the text and some bit of, exploration as well. There will be obviously, but then now these 25 questions, if you learn thoroughly, so the first two pages are done. Likewise, every two pages, 25 questions are generated objective type. Your entire geography course is done. There are only six chapters in geography of grade 9. First chapter is done. We are having 25 questions today on first two pages. Okay, so here we start. Okay, no, if at all there is some discrepancy, we'll talk about it later. Okay, so one, two, three, and start.
Do there, whether it works or not, is different.
First question. So here is the first question on the screen. So please watch my screen for question because it might be smaller in font in your screen. Right? So first of the first question, the very first page of your book, you can see and you can answer. Okay? So now they have made some changes in the di display, the Menti people. So there is no more number of people would be visible, how many have voted. So hence it's kind of depressurizing all of you. So just go through your, options and mark it very peacefully. Okay, so 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, here is the first leaderboard. Oh, first answer. Yes. This was very, very easy. I don't know why people have made it wrong. So forests are not part of physical, geological or, physiological. So yeah, so if you see this, right, so there is no mention of any forest here. Okay, so right, very good. So let's go to next question. Before that, the first leaderboard. No, you have just six chapters in geography. Oh, in NAFL there will be different. Yeah. Okay, so first person, Jayant is back in the game. Good one, Jayant. Very good. Okay, so let's go to the next question. Excuse me, guys. Oh, next question. Okay, read carefully. Read very, very carefully. The questions might need a careful, and all questions, by the way, would require a careful reading. But yeah, you know how I twist the question at times just to make you fall in a trap. So, okay. Yes, last 3, 2, 1. Go. Amazing. So, okay, now that means you have read the rest. This, what was the question, by the way? Let me also share the screen here. Oh, I have the question here itself, so no problem. Okay, so the question was here. This was the question. Okay, very, very easy question. Okay, so India has all major physical features. Yes, they have first page itself. India doesn't enjoy. These are self-contradictory statement. Okay, so hence, if someone has all major physical features, how can it not enjoy great physical variation? So hence, one is correct, but two is incorrect. Yes, Vibha, you can always unmute and say. But I don't know whether I'm able to hear you guys. Yes, I will be able to. Isn't it perceptive? No. See, India has all major physical features mentioned in the line. India doesn't enjoy great physical variation. So all major, there is nothing, no physical feature in the world which India doesn't have. So hence, there is a lot of variation, isn't it? So hence, C is correct. Okay, so let's go to the next question. Leaderboard first. Okay, this is the... Oh, so Tarun was fastest this time and there is some shuffling. Never mind, it's just the second question. So good going, guys. Let's go to the next question. And let's see how much do you know about physical features of India. Okay, here is the next question, folks. Very, very easy. 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 Yep, it's very much written in the very first paragraph of your, right? So please retain these facts because all your tests, unit test, exam questions will be based. This is the textbook which I posted, Vibha. Right? Oh, still many people. Oh, that means how come? How is that possible? How is that possible? So this was Deccan Plateau is the oldest one, right? Why did you put Himalayas? Deccan Plateau is the oldest plateau. So this is mentioned in your book. You can see where I don't know where, but I picked it from somewhere. Anyways, so somewhere it is there. Which line I know? I will not be able to find it now. One of the ancient land masses on the Earth's surface. Can you see geologically the peninsular plateau constitutes one of the ancient land masses on the Earth's surface? Okay, so it's very much there. Next question. Leaderboard. Okay. So the leaderboard, Srijan Ghosh comes up. Abhishek. Okay, so nice. Next, let's go to next question. Okay, next question is this. Consider the following statements. This is application based. So hence, read thoroughly. Hence, I have given 10 extra seconds for this question. See. Read the question carefully. Five, four, three, two, one. Right? So hence, let's see. Oh. Wow, that's nice. So people have read the book.
On C.
That's good. So this is the...
Yeah, your headphones got this.
Yeah. Just you put your mic on mute, guys. Okay. Now... Consider the following statement. The Himalayan mountains are more prone to earthquakes and landslides than the Deccan Plateau. Yes, that's true. Himalayan mountains are less stable. This is mentioned. And since they are less stable, hence most of the time you'll see lots of landslides and earthquake issues in the Himalayan mountains. So clearly second is a right explanation for the first one. So hence A is true. And most of you have got it right. Very good. Let's go to the leaderboard now. Okay, so yeah, lots of people are now in the fray. That's nice. Okay, so people have read the book properly this time. Jayant, you are getting a good competition, dude, with others now. Okay, let's go to the next one. Okay, so this is question number 5. Okay, someone is not in mute. So please mute yourself. That will be a good, because I am having some technical issue. So I'll not be able to do it from here. So you guys can do it yourself. I know most of you would have marked it incorrectly. Guessed it. You did not guess it. Oh, see, I told you. Right, only 9 people have got it correct. So that means you didn't study it properly and didn't read the question either. So, question number 5 was it, right? Yes. So, which of the following statement? Incorrect. Presence of igneous rock indicates the old age of the Deccan Plateau. That is very, very correct. So, the question was to find out incorrect. If you see here, incorrect. Okay. So, I think most of you would have done the other way around. Okay. Now, presence of igneous rocks indicate the old age. Yes, igneous rocks represent old age because, these are volcanic in origin. Okay. High peaks, deep valleys and fast flowing rivers indicate relatively young age of the Himalayas. This is also mentioned in the book. So, both 1 and 2 are correct. Northern plains are made up of alluvial deposits. So, alluvial deposits are there. Hence it indicates is youthful age, not the old age. So, third one is definitely incorrect. And that's what you had to pick. So, answer was B. Okay. Okay. So, hence B was the right answer. So, what is the learning? Learning is Deccan Plateau is oldest. So, igneous rocks indicates the old age. Himalayas are, high peaks, deep valleys, fast flowing rivers indicate their young age. And northern plains are made up of alluvial deposits, which also indicate that they are recent, not old. Okay. So, hence, it is also there in the textbook. Okay. So, if someone would have read it properly, he would have got it. Okay. So, the next leaderboard is this one. Oh my God. Only 3 out of the top 10. That's amazing. Okay. So, Jayant is back on top. Great. Okay. Next. Ready, guys? Again, correct, incorrect, check. There will be traps in the question. Even the options are easy, I know. But there will be traps in the question. Okay. Again. So, if the font size is little odd, you can just increase it at your end. Which of the following statement are incorrect? So, I read it. This one is... Oh, Vedant, why no misclicking? This you would have learned many a times whenever geography session would have been, easy, right? Sad. So, which one? Okay, so most of you have got it correct, but lots of people have not got it correct. So, what was there between the, that Indian mainland was, hey, you're not aware of Tethys Sea? Tethys Sea, there was a sea between Indian mainland and Eurasian plate, right? So, how did Himalayas originate? How did they come into, existence? Okay. Please show questions and answers. Okay. So, let me show you the next one. So, this is question number 6. This was the question, right? So, the place where the Himalayas are located now was something called Tethys Sea. It was not a desert, it was a sea. And the Eurasian plate, the north of Himalaya and the Indian mainland, right? So, I don't know if you are aware of Gondwana land and all that. So, the two, hit each other and the Tethys Sea, which was there, buckled up. And that is now today called Himalayas. And hence, Himalayas are called New Fold Mountains, right? So, imagine, yeah. So, two land masses colliding and these, earth crust between them just buckling up and becoming mountain, right? So, the name of the sea was Tethys, T-E-T-H-Y-S. Okay, so this is the source, or let's say, how did Himalaya come into being? Next, so leaderboard. Okay, so you need to have some bit of knowledge about why Himalayas are called fold mountains. Okay, here is the updated leaderboard. Let's go to the next question. Monisha and Viva, I'll connect you guys, don't worry. So you can interact about books there. Okay, so let's do questions here, okay? So don't worry, I will connect you two people. So you can just talk about your book list and all that and involve me also, so I'll also participate. Okay, so here is the question. Arrange the following places in ascending order of water current of the river Ganga at these places: Haridwar, Gangotri, Allahabad, Sundarban Delta. Okay, so where is the water current lowest to highest? So you need not guess it. This is there in your book. Code is there, Prateek, on the screen. 334697. See, only 7 got it. Okay, so this question required knowledge of two things. First, yes. So as you come down from Himalaya, the water velocity or speed comes down, right? So it reduces. Why? It will be highest in the Himalayan region and lowest towards the delta. So you could have figured out from the options itself. So the water current is lowest in the delta. Okay, so hence C and D are eliminated. A and B are there, Sundarban Delta. Now Allahabad is downstream to Haridwar. I hope you know this. Haridwar is where Ganga enters the plain. Okay, so at Haridwar, it's very swift, very fast. I don't know if you have visited Haridwar, any of you. So if you see the water current over there, it's very fast. Very, very fast, yes. Ascending order, hence. You know, so you have to, highest current, ascending. So Gangotri has the highest current, no? It is at the steepest possible places. Correct? So the current will be very, very fast. This is not there in the first two pages. This is actually, you know, see. Okay. So I'll show you where fast flowing rivers. Do you see this? The whole mountain system of Himalaya represents a very useful topography with high peaks, deep valleys and fast flowing rivers. Fast flowing rivers is the catch here. Right? So hence, towards the Himalaya, Gangotri is in Himalaya, so there the velocity will be highest. Velocity will be highest, isn't it? So hence application. You have to apply your knowledge. Next. Leaderboard. With respect to what it is ascending, so where is it not clear? Arrange the following places in ascending order of water current of the river Ganges at these places. Okay, so where is the lowest? Ascending means first lowest. Where is the lowest? Obviously speed. Current is speed, buddy. Arthur. So lowest speed is in Sundarban Delta. Okay. And highest speed is in Gangotri. So where is the order not clear? Isn't it? Ascending order of speed means lowest to highest. Right? I hope this is clear. So hence, lowest speed is in Sundarban Delta. Highest speed is in Gangotri. Okay? So hence, now, next. Okay. This is again directly from the book. Just twisted, that's it. Change the active to passive voice. So you should be reading line by line like that. And the best way is to, if at all you want to do it, that's how you have to. But don't worry, I'll give you this PPT. It becomes your notes so that you go through these. English Sentoma. For that, you have to conduct that, Vibha. Sorry, I can't. Oh my God. So this is equally divided between B and C. Guessed. Why? Why are you guessing? Which of the following statement are correct? India doesn't have coastal plains. Wrong. Utterly wrong. Wrong statement. India does have coastal plain. So one is definitely incorrect. Himalayas, the northern plains and the Deccan Plateau is the correct north-south order. Yes. Northern Himalayas, then plains, then Deccan Plateau. So second one is right. So only two is right. So B is correct. So B is correct. Increase little time. Now not possible. Next time. So you have to. Hence I give you the book. I have been telling you that the next chapter. In the last centamar only I told you. Okay. So here is the new leaderboard. Next. Okay. So solve this now. Directly lifted from the book. Which two rivers make the boundary of the east-west stretch of the Himalayas? Which two rivers mark the boundary of the east-west stretch of Himalayas? Very easy. Directly lifted from the book. Yeah, see? Most of you. Okay, great. So, very, very, very easy. So, answer was Indus in the west and Brahmaputra in the east. Right? So, you know, the Brahmaputra comes from China, takes a right turn, gets into Indian mainland, you know, around Arunachal Pradesh, and then enters Assam. From there, enters Bangladesh and then get merged with Bay of Bengal, right? So, Brahmaputra on the east and Indus on the west. So, no, it's a totally factual question and it was directly from your book. Next leaderboard. Okay, so, okay, all of you have got it right. So, that's nice. So, that means you have studied this question. Fair enough. Okay, so let's go to next question. Which of the following statements is or are correct about the Himalayas? They represent loftiest and most rugged mountains barriers in the world. They are wider in the east as compared to west. Directly lifted from your book. Okay, guessed again, no problem. So here is, oh, so people have got it wrong. Why? Most of the people have got it wrong. This was very simple, yeah. It's there in the book.
Sir?
Yes, sir.
But shouldn't it be C? Because it's loftiest and one of the most rugged mountains. It's also written that Eastern Arc is altitudinal variation is greater than the Western Arc, sir. So it should be both one and two, right?
No. We are talking about wider. Altitude is vertically yes, vertical direction. Wider is width. How wide?
Sir, but where is the width part written? Sir, they wrote 400 kilometers in Kashmir and 150 kilometers in Arunachal Pradesh.
Jagrav, just hold for 2 minutes. Hold. Yeah. You will get the answer. Just hold on, because there is something.
Okay, sir.
So hence, just hold on. You'll get the answer. I'll tell you the answer also. So, which of the following statements is are correct? So only first one is correct. Okay, they are not wider in the east. They are wider in the west. Okay, so hence only one is correct. Right? Now you will see why this was correct. Okay. So I have just removed the data, buddies. Just remove the data and, you know, you have to. Okay. Never mind. And here goes the next question. Now you will understand why. Why did I give that question to you? Now you will understand. Again, directly lifted from the book, only changed something. Jagrav is giving hints. Jagrav, don't do that. Okay, great. So only B is correct. Okay, finally you read it correctly because the order of the width was given wrongly and hence I asked you to hold because 150 kilometer wide is in Arunachal and 400 kilometer wide is in Kashmir. So Kashmir is in on the west side, western side of Arunachal. So hence it goes on decreasing. The width, you know, goes on decreasing. Did you get the answer? Now, Jagrav, western side is more wider, eastern side is lesser wide. Okay, too easy, but then, so all this is becoming your notes, guys. You don't need to go through this again and again. So if you have all these 25 questions, first two pages are done forever. Okay, next. So, Fair enough. Here is, okay, all of you, the top 10 have got it correctly. That's nice that you are reading the questions very, very carefully. Cool. Next question, guys. Here is the next question. Okay, here is the next question. Which of the following statement is our correct? Is our correct? Is our correct? Raghav Pandey, problem is that we have a different textbook and we don't even have this chapter. No problem, hence, you know, we will keep your geography also, don't worry. Hence, I gave you open internet, open book. Everything is there at your disposal. Okay, let me see how many people have got it correct. I will be very happy. Ow! Wonderful, 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 wonderful. What is the issue? What was the issue? What was the issue? Yes, people didn't notice that. I have not given you meters. I had given you feet. It was 6,000 feet. And you did not read this properly. Okay, so hence you made the, so again re-emphasizing. Why do you, Tanvi, it's not that I feel, you know, very pleasure doing all that, but then what is the lesson you guys are getting? Why, what is the lesson? Lesson is, you are so tempted to mark it, incarnation of evil. Oh my God, Jayant, don't curse me, buddies. The thing is, if I don't do this here, you, everybody is cursing me. Okay, okay. Don't worry, don't worry. It is going to benefit you all. It's going to benefit you all only. So hence, please, hence, take time. See, there are 9 people who got it correct. So that's also you should appreciate. So my dear friends, take time, read carefully, no? Read carefully. Okay, so here is the leaderboard. So it will create lots of upheavals. Okay, here is the, oh, only 2 from the top 2, top 10. That's nice. So it will create some difference now. Okay, so Raghav and Jayant now are on. Okay, so hence, there will be such traps ahead as well. So please, again telling you, stay calm. Stay calm and read full. Read in full and carefully. Here is the next one. Someone was asking about the map thing. Here is a question from the map. I don't know if you have cared to see the map. So still, you know, go to the map and mark it. I'm saying, go to the map, see, find all these places. These are very much there. Find out. In the book, the map is there. The map is there. You can still, 9 seconds, 8 seconds, find out. Northern plain, northern side. Okay, so I hope people would have taken this advice of going to the map. Okay, so see, it means people have not paid attention to that. So here is the map. If you read map, map is very, very important. See, here is Pamir North, right? Kunlun Mountains, all outside India. Here is Mansarovar Lake, which is in Tibet. And Suleiman Range is in Pakistan. So just by seeing this, you would have got it correct. I told you it's an open book. Okay, so never mind. So let's go to the leaderboard. Right. So, okay. So, but thankfully, most of you have got it. Most of you have got it. Okay. That's nice. Good. Good. Okay. So let's go to the next question. Again, be careful. Careful. Read question properly. Read question properly. Yes, you can still, yeah, this is something Google, you can Google. This is lifted from, that you have to find out the peaks which are located in India. By name itself, you can figure out. It's there in the book, yes. There's a table in the book from where I have lifted it. So you must. Okay, so easy one again. Oh, still only 24 could get it. It was here mentioned. See, all are mentioned here, this table. So you could have just, yep. So everything is from the book which you have been given. Can you give more time? Okay. Tanvi, not today. It will be impossible to change timings because then I have to exit the quiz. See, Ashish and all others, it is different from maths and science concepts. This is about whether you know it or you don't know it. So if you don't know it, you can't solve it, right? It's not like maths that, okay, you put in some more time and then you will get it. It's not going to happen, right? So hence, what I'm saying is either you know it or you don't know it. This is our quiz question, typical fact-based. So if I give more time, you will only end up searching on the net. That's it. So that means, you know, it's anyways not going to help much. Open book means you have to go through once. Obviously, if I give you Ramayana and ask you questions from Ramayana, you will not be able to solve questions like that. So hence, you have to have some kind of idea, right? Where exactly you can find out.
So can you please show the question?
Yes, why not? Here is the question. This was the question? No. This was the question? No. This was the question. Yes. Which range is not in India? So Dholagiri is in Nepal. Everything else is in India. Okay. Very good. Next. So this is again, all are these points which are becoming your class notes, guys. If you think you can, you know, Ramayana quiz. Oh my God. I don't have that much knowledge of Ramayana. Yeah. Sorry. Okay. So here is the next leaderboard and the next question. Okay. Here is the, yes. Now this you must know. Now you can use common sense to guess it. Okay. Yes. So you could use elimination, right? So everyone knows there is one in chaos. See, most of you have got it actually. Nice. That's nice. Cool. So it was very easy. So Annamudi is in Kerala. It's in Western Ghats, highest peak in South India. But it is somewhere around 2,000 some odd meters, right? And Nanda Devi and Kanchan.
Yes. Sir, could you tell me the code again? My thing got shut.
Code is 334697. Okay. Yep. So Nanda Devi is in Uttarakhand, correct? Kanchanjunga is in Sikkim, right? So Kanchanjunga is actually border between Sikkim and Nepal. Okay, so one side is India, another side is Nepal. Okay, so remember that. Next. Here it is. Oh. Okay, so Jayant is back on top. Great. Good. Nice. Next. Voice breaking. Sorry, yeah. Technical stuff today, we are also having some issues, but I hope it's fine. Okay. Again, careful. Don't curse me if you get it wrong. Careful. Lifted from book directly. We will have Viva. No, don't worry. It was popular choice, hence. Good, Tanvi. Thanks. Don't curse me, buddy. So this is only for you. You will get it. You will thank me later on. Just mark my words. Because of your things, this thing. Okay. So thankfully this time people have read a little bit more. Great. So this was clear in this question. The Himadri range is made up of symmetrical folds. Thank you. Yes. Yeah. Please put it mute. You listen to your music, you know, yourself. Don't let us hear that. So here is a paragraph. The folds of the Great Himalayas are asymmetrical in nature. So that is wrong. The statement given in the slide is wrong. The core of this part of Himalaya is composed of granite, right? It is perennially snowbound, so there is no season, right? No season, winter or summer. It's perennially snowbound, right? And a number of glaciers descend from this range, right? So hence, only first two are incorrect. These two are incorrect. Third one is correct, right? So only three. So A was the, sorry. So it was asking incorrect. So which two are incorrect? One and two. So third, C. Sorry, B, one and two only. Okay. So here is the, no, Pranav, three was correct. So the question was to find out which are incorrect. Okay, very good. Next. Okay. Here. This must, the moment you see glacier, you must inquire, what is a glacier? What is a glacier? So are they bodies of dense ice? No, they are made up of sand. Are they, do they move under their own weight? Do they move at all? They are the largest reservoir of fresh water in the world. Okay, so all three were correct. So most of you have got it correct. That's nice. So just for your fact, glaciers are frozen ice or dense ice. Next, they have, they move under their own weight. So how do you know they move? It's given in, you can infer from here. It is perennially snowbound and a number of glaciers descend from this range. Descend means obviously how do they descend? Someone is pushing them. No. So hence, yep.
So I have a doubt.
Please go ahead.
So in the last question, it was written like for the northernmost range or Himadri range, it's asymmetrical in nature. So does that mean the same thing as symmetrical? Like what is the difference?
No. Not asymmetrical. The folds of the Great Himalayas are asymmetrical in nature. I have just copied this statement. See. First statement. Page number 2. The folds of the Great Himalayas are asymmetrical in nature. And what was the line? Line was, the Himadri range is made up of symmetrical folds. So A was missing. Right? Understood. So it is made up of asymmetrical folds, not symmetrical folds. Okay. So clear. This is done. So let's go ahead and see the leaderboard. Okay, here is the new, some change is happening. Oh, that's nice. Flip flop. Okay, now next is this question. This is a good question. I don't know. Google quick. But Google is wrong. That's the point. Google is not correct all the time. No, Vibha. Don't demonize me, buddy. I'm a good guy. I want all of you to excel. Okay. Google help. Okay. So, oh my God. Hey, Right. That's what happened. What happened? Where was the question? So, yeah, all three are in India. Yes. Now, Baltoro is in Gilgit-Baltistan, which is very much legally part of India. Though it is in POK, it's very much part of India. India holds the legal right. No, Siachen is in India today. I don't know if you have... You have not... oh, my God. This is something which you must...
Sir, is Siachen the LOC of India and Pakistan?
So, Siachen, yes. So, LOC runs through... See, I don't know if you're aware. This is very, very interesting thing, guys. So, let me... you must know this. Just give me 2 minutes so that I can... you know, what do you say, enlighten you a bit. See, if you see Siachen, are you must know, yeah, this is the highest battlefield in the world. I don't know if you are aware of this. Highest battlefield. So, can you see the triangle? See, this is Siachen Glacier. Can you see the triangle here? See. Let me show you. Can you see this? Oh. There is a this triangle. Can you see this triangle? This triangle is Siachen Glacier. It's the highest battlefield in the world. Now, this line which you see, this line, just follow my cursor, right? This line is claimed by India as the border line. And this line is claimed by Pakistan as the border line. Okay? And we are currently in possession of this glacier. This glacier is very strategic for India. Why? Why is this glacier very strategic? This glacier is very strategic to India. This is China here. This is our Ladakh. And this is Kyrgyzstan, right? So, right? Okay, yes. So, very, very strategically placed. And Siachen Glacier today is under India's possession. You must watch a YouTube video on Siachen Glacier. You will be, the temperatures there is minus 50 degrees centigrade, almost. And it is manned by our army personnel over there. Negative 50. Okay? It goes to negative 50. Freezing, right? And Gilgit, here is somewhere the Baltoro Glacier, which feeds a tributary of Indus. Okay, and you know, Gangotri is somewhere here. I don't exactly, we'll have to just check the map. And all of them are the feeders of Indian rivers. So I would urge everyone to go and study a little bit about Siachen Glacier. Very, very crucial. So many Indians have lost their life saving that glacier. Very interesting story. If you are interested in war stories, that is. Next. So here is. So Baltoro is in Gilgit, Baltistan, which is in current day. Very much part of. Okay. Don't. Yeah. Very much part of India. Okay. Here is the next question. Next, this you must know. This is again picked up directly from the map. Directly from the map. Easy. Once you read the book, everything becomes easy, isn't it? Great. Okay, so most of you have got it correct. That's nice. All was lifted from the map here. So you can see Tsangpo is the river, which is also called Brahmaputra in India. Okay, then Jaskar Range, you can see it here. And what, in Sikkim, there is something called Nathula, which is very, I don't know, it was mentioned here, somewhere it was there. Okay, so by 2-3 choices itself, you can end. Namcha Barwa, here is the peak. Can you see this, Namcha Barwa? Okay, so here is the, yes, great. Amazing, no? Janvi, amazing place, Nathula Pass. Okay, here is the beautiful, nature is beautiful there. Okay, next is the leaderboard. I am not, you know, being, you know, or having pity on anyone. You guys are intelligent, so you are figuring it out now. Okay, so next question. If you study, no one can deny your, you know, rightful place. That's it. That's the message. Now, talk of pass, and you must know these famous passes of India. Come on, you all of you are much intelligent than me, so don't worry. Okay, when I was there at your age, I was very, you know, I was too dumb. We'll tell you stories later on, but here right now, passes. So those who have visited, some of them, they must know, they would be knowing, and you must know all of them. You must know these are very, very important passes. Okay. So let me see. Okay. So most of you got it correct. That's really cool. So let me just tell you. So Nathula Pass is in Sikkim. So it separates Sikkim and Tibet. So many people already had guessed it. Now Banihal Pass is between Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir valleys are separated by Banihal Pass. Very, very strategic again. Zozila Pass differentiates or separates Ladakh and Kashmir. Very, very important pass. And Rohtang is between Manali and Lahaul. Okay, so that's Lahaul is in Himachal Pradesh. Lahaul and Spiti, very, very beautiful valleys, you know. Okay, yes, correct. Namrata. Now, next question. Okay, another shuffle. Okay, so here is the next. So next time you go for an outing, please remember the geography of that place. Lesser Himalayas now. Directly lifted from your book. Good. So, very good. So, it shows most of you are getting it correct. So, the correct explanation is they are also known as Himachal. It's mentioned in your book. They are to the north of Himadri. False statement. Himadri is to the north of Himachal. So this thing is Himadri, Himachal, Shivaliks, right? First Himadri, then Himachal, then Shivalik from north to south. And they are mainly composed of highly compressed and altered rocks directly lifted from here. You can see first few lines. The ranges are mainly composed of highly compressed and altered rocks. Okay. So, well done. If you have, okay, here is the leaderboard. The correct answer. So, the correct answer was 1 and 3 was correct. Okay. Next. Now, the intention behind such kind of questions is it should not be direct as well as it should be factful so that later on you can use this as your notes also. You can just, I will share the PPT with you all. You can tweak a little bit and make it as your notes. Right? All the information is there. But then you have to know it properly. Hey, it's very much there in your book only. Very much there in the book. Oh, many people got it wrong. So let me first show you the question. Which of the following statements are correct? So their average height ranges between 3,700 4,500 meter. Hence they are higher than the Himadri. Obviously no, it's not correct. It's not correct. It's not higher than the Himadri because you just learned in the previous some slides earlier that the Himadri had 6,000 meters height. Okay. Their average width is 50 kilometer. Hence, they are lesser in width than the Himadri. Very true, because Himadri had what? 150 to 400 kilometers width. Okay. Isn't it? So, hence, yes. Yeah, so, you must read it carefully. That was the intent of this entire quiz. So, hence, both first is incorrect, second is correct. So, only two is correct. Okay, Sunena, next time, more time, done. Right? So, little bit of pre-read can help you. Okay? Still, people are getting it correct. That's really, really encouraging. Very good, guys. Okay, so here is the next one. directly lifted from your book. Go search. Easy. Easy, easy. Okay. So all of those who have read the book, they say easy. Okay. Very good. So hence you have read the book. It was directly from the book. The question was, what was the question, by the way? The question was, Karakoram is not there. Peer Panjal, Dholadhar and Mahabharat is there in your book itself. It's mentioned. Right? So hence 1, 3 and 4. 1, 3 and 4 are where? D. So, D is correct. So, it's very much there in your book. Here, see. Peer Panjal, Dholadhar and Mahabharat. Okay. So, if you just go through. See, in 2 pages, we got 25 questions. And you are now. Mahabharat is the name of the range, Tanvi. Range. Okay. Very good. So, now, next question. Second last question of the evening. Directly lifted from the book. Ta-da! Becomes note. Too easy. Where is Karakoram? Karakoram is in Himadri, north of Himachal. Why direct questions? Now it's closing time. No. See, still. Can you see that irony? Direct question still. Right? So, hence, if you see, it's mentioned. Valley of Kashmir, Kangra and Kulu. Everything was mentioned over there. But then, never mind. Your wish. Lesser Himalayas? Okay, I'll show. Monisha. You didn't find Lesser Himalayas. Okay. Okay, this is the... That's temperament, my dear friend. You have to win over your temperament. That's the intent. Knowledge only will not help. You have to be balanced and calm and composed. Last one. And damn easy. No one should mess it up. Very, very easy. Right? The last question of the evening. Get ready for celebrations. Right? It's very much the last line of your... Yeah, so okay, so drum roll. So it was lifted from this region is well known for its hill stations. This region is well known. Every line in NCERT book can be converted into question. That's the message I am trying to send to all. Correct? If you make notes like this, it is one time affair and you will be champion. Okay, so what was I saying? Monisha, here is the word Himachal or Lesser Himalaya. See, so is known as Himachal or Lesser Himalaya. Okay, so it's very much there in the book. There is nothing which is not there in the book. You have to be reading using a lens. Okay, so guys, who is the first person? Guesses before we show you. The leaderboard. First, who came first? Monisha. Okay, Jayant has a lot of fan following. Jayant. Okay, Gandhar, Vihan. Okay, and here is the final one. Okay. And, Jayant is still the winner. Well done, Jayant. Congratulations. Congratulations, very well done. Keep it up. So this is second time in a row Jayant has topped the list. Amazing feat. Great, great, good. Well done, well done. Keep it up, keep it up. You know, all of you clap for Jayant. So that's really good feat. Great, really amazing. And Abhishek, Vandar, Raghav, Nishant, Anuya, Bharat, Rihan, Sujan Ghosh and Surandita Mishra. All of you, really well done. Very good. Keep it up. I hope you are enjoying these kind of sessions. And you are learning as well. Okay? So, thanks. Thanks. Thanks a lot. Thank you. Thank you for anything. Okay, great. Great. Very good. Very good. Very good. I hope this is making sense to you. You are connecting with the subject matter. You are understanding. You are retaining the facts. My sincere wish is you stay calm and composed. You know, improve your skills or temperament, you know, exam handling skills, right? It will help you. So don't curse me because otherwise I will not get a good food. So hence, okay? All the best to everyone and good night to you. Bye-bye. Thanks.
Sir, so again, next two pages for next class?
Yes, next two pages, next class. Okay? And 25 questions. Bye-bye. Take care. Good night. Thank you.